Thank you. City Councilman John House is in the house. Pat Hugerly Green. Lula Lunsford. Huff, excuse me. And we want you to also place in your heart a prayer for our Mayor Pro Tem, our Sarah Evelyn Turner Pugh. Today I'm going to preside over this event. My name is Maddie Hall. It is my pleasure to stand before you and congratulate you all on a beautiful weekend of celebrating 106 years of our founding. We had 22 founders, and one of those founders is really a name that's very important to our community, Winona Cargile Alexander. We're so happy to be able to make something wonderful happen in our community that we can always share and pass on to our children, to our neighbors, to the state of Georgia. At this time, we're going to look at your program. We're going to follow it. My sorority, Deja, will come forward, and she's going to bring the welcome and the occasion, and then we're going to have the litany, and you can follow along with that in your program.
Of serving as the Theta Phi Chapter's Founders Day Committee Chairperson. I would like to extend a warm welcome to you as you witness a truly historic event commemorating one of the beloved founders of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, Incorporated. 4 years ago, my chapter began a journey to accomplish a noteworthy duty in honor of founder Winona Cargile Alexander. Founder Alexander walked the very ground that we stand on today. She was a woman beyond worthy of such a recognition as this. Making it a point to always be herself, her infectious personality appealed to many people. Throughout her life, founder Winona Cargile Alexander accomplished many noble things. She was a teacher, a trailblazer, a server of her community, an activist of change. Because of the strides she made during in her life, we should all be encouraged to be the best that we can be, regardless of any obstacles presented along our path. May she live, may the life she lived and the bravery she exuded serve as an inspiration to us all who are gathered today. To the members of Columbus Alumni and Columbus Metropolitan Alumni Chapters who have stood beside us and worked with us every step of the way, your wisdom and insight have made this labor of love a success. I cannot thank you women enough for all that you have done. It has been an honor to serve as chair of the Historical Marker Committee and learning from each of you. Thank you.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
We will now hear from our Delta Corps leaders. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Cornelius. The next item on our program, I would ask for our regional directors, Sandra K. Horton and Geraldine West, of me to come forward.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a litany of remembrance. It is found in your program if you would join in. We remember now with joy and thanksgiving the life of Winona Cargile Alexander in the rising of the sun and its going down.
We remember her.
In the blowing of the wind and in the chill of winter.
We remember her.
And in the business of the skies, in the blueness of the skies, and in the warmth of summer.
We remember her.
At the beginning of the year and when it ends.
We remember her.
As long as we live, she too shall live, for she is a part of us.
We remember her.
In remembering of Winona Cargile Alexander, we are gathered into a common bond of hope, memory, and love, which strengthens our being woven into the fabric of God's creation. And the great cloud of witnesses surrounding us, adapted from Gates of Prayer and Form, Judaism and Prayer.
Thank you. At this time, I ask our regional director, our National Archives, and member to proceed to the unveiling over to the left. In our chapter paper from 3 to 5, go down the aisle.
We're doing it. I got a video. I got it on Facebook Live. Five chapters.
Yeah, that's smart.
I'm sorry.
Six, five, four, three, two, one.
Woo!
And that is the dedication of Winona Cargile Alexander. Hope you enjoyed.